بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين وحبيب الله وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد، صل على محمد وآل محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Muharram, a new year has begun in the Islamic calendar. Muharram is basically the start of the new Islamic calendar, in the same way that you find, for example, in the Gregorian calendar, which is the calendar of the Western world, you find that they have a new year. Whenever they have a new year, they have a new resolution to their new year. They have a new start to their new year. They try and change what is within themselves. They try and have goals and ambitions to try and improve their own selves within this new year. But they greet it with happiness, while we greet our new year with sadness and grief on what has occurred to the Imam, the grandson of the Prophet, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, which is known as the self of the Holy Prophet himself. So when we mourn Imam Hussein, we mourn no other than the Holy Prophet himself, for he is the flesh and the blood of the Prophet, the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet would say, Hussein is from me and I am from Hussein. Now the first bit is very well understood. Hussein is from me. The Prophet says Hussein is from the Prophet, because he is the grandson of the Prophet. He's of the same blood of the Prophet. He's of the same lineage of the Prophet. But then he says, "But I am from Hussein." How can the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, be from Hussein alayhi salam? In what way and how? You find that if the Prophet came to bring the religion of Islam to humanity, and Imam Hussein came to save that same religion, to expand that same religion, to perfect that same religion, to make people understand that religion. For if it wasn't for Imam Hussein, the religion of the Prophet would have wept away and it would have gone. So therefore you find Hussein is from the Prophet, in the sense that he carried on the message of him, of the Holy Prophet, of the Islam, and he saved the message of Islam. For if it wasn't for the sacrifice of Imam Hussein, Islam would have perished. So therefore we look at the sacrifice of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, we look at this new year, and we look within ourselves. Imam Hussein alayhi salam started a revolution. He started something great within himself and within the whole Islamic Ummah. In the same way that we should start a revolution within ourselves in this new year. In this new year, we look at the story, we look at the incident, we look at the event of Karbala and the event of Ashura. And we do not let it sweep away just like any other year. We do not become religious for 10 days, for 1 month, and then let it go. No, Imam Hussein alayhi salam is for every year, for every day, for every second. Every day is Karbala, every year is Karbala, every day is Ashura, is the same thing. The whole concept is that Imam Hussein lives within us in our every day and every moment. Because Karbala is the same. He fought, he revolutionized the self before he revolutionized anything else. And in that same way, we have to revolutionize ourselves so we can become like Imam Hussein and like the companions of Imam Hussein and the true followers of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. This is the message for me before it's for anyone else. When we look at Imam Hussein alayhi salam, inshallah, what we will try and do is within these 15 minutes, 10-15 minutes that we have in English, we will try and look at the personalities of the companions of Imam Hussein so we can look at their characteristics and become like them. For when we look at the event of Karbala, we find three groups of people. We find the group of people that went with Imam Hussein at the beginning, and they were in their thousands, that told Imam Hussein to come towards them because they will support him, and they were in their thousands and thousands in Kufa when they sent their letters. But in the end, most of these thousands all went away from Imam Hussein. They left him and they went towards their houses, their worldly life, their luxuries, these kind of things. Their hearts were filled with the love of this world as well as the love of Allah and religion and the Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And two loves cannot fit in one heart. They were not dedicated to their religion enough to say, okay, we will leave this world, we will leave the families, we'll leave our work, we'll leave everything behind for Imam Hussein, for sacrifice for the sake of Islam. They were not willing to do that. You find the other group who are fighting against Imam Hussein. Now, a lot of people will think these people are really bad. These people, they were terrible. They did not pray, they did not fast. In fact, they prayed, they fasted. Some of them were reported to pray the Salat al-Layl all their lives. And in fact, not only did they do that, but some of them loved Imam Hussein, yet they fought against him. سيوفنا قلوبنا معك وسيوفنا عليك, they would say. Our hearts are with you, but our swords are against you. These are the second group of people. These group of people were who? Were those who they say they love Imam Hussein in their words, but in their actions, they oppose the teachings of Imam Hussein. When it comes to the time of prayer, they avoid the prayer, they leave the prayer. When it comes to doing what is good, they leave what is good and they go towards what is haram. Yet they love Imam Hussein, they say, we are your followers, and they come to these majalis and they love Imam Hussein. Yet they oppose him in their actions. And that is the characteristics of those who opposed him. And then there was the third characteristics of people. They were those who stood by Imam Hussein, and they were very few. There were only 72 in number. In the same way that when Imam Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif comes, there will only be a few that will be with him. There are many that say, we want to be with you, O Imam Mahdi. In the same way that there were many who said, we want to be with you, O Hussein. But it was only the very few that stayed steadfast on this path towards Imam Hussein alayhi salam and towards the truth. So inshallah, we will look into the lives of these people and the characteristics that they held, and we will try to uphold these characteristics within our life and change ourselves and revolutionize what is within, because that is the true jihad, that is the true sacrifice that we need to do, and it's all about sacrifice. So if you take anything from this talk, understand the word ithar. Ithar means sacrifice. Ithar means altruism. Ithar means preferring others to yourself, preferring what is good to yourself. It means getting up and sacrificing our time, our comfort for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, for the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. And only then can we truly revolutionize our own self and the whole Islamic Ummah inshaAllah and become better people. So therefore, from these nights and from the following nights onwards, we need to understand just three R's. Three R's. The first R is to reflect. To reflect on what happened at the time of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and these nights. The second R is to make a resolution to change ourselves to become like Imam Hussein and the companions of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And then after we reflected, after we made the resolution, we can then revolutionize ourselves to become a new person, a new individual, where we sit down and we write, okay, this is a new Islamic year, what am I going to change in my life, in the life, so I can be of the true companions of Imam Hussein. And it's very relevant to our day, because only those who held the characteristics of the companions of Imam Hussein will be of those who support Imam Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu when he arrives. So therefore, let us try and become better within ourselves, and I send this message to myself before anyone else, and inshallah the tawfiq is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And understand that to improve ourselves, to become righteous, the Holy Quran says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will not reach this point of righteousness, this point of birr, this point of goodness, until you leave that which you love. If you love rest, if you love comfort, if you love all these things, leave it for the sake of Allah. Get up for the Fajr prayers. Get up for these important duties that Islam has held upon us. And let's try to purify our heart and be sincere towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, because that is the only true path of being everlasting in this world and the next, as Imam Hussein alayhi salam clearly showed us through his revolution, where the gatherings of Imam Hussein grow year after year, where whenever anyone else dies, the first time, a lot of people come, a lot of flowers are put to their graves, but every year they decrease, except for Imam Hussein's grave, where the gatherings, where the love of Imam Hussein increases year after year. The time span is greater, is longer, is more distant, but the love of Imam Hussein is greater and more vibrant than ever in this day of age and in every age. So let us be true to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and let us try and follow on his footpath and of the companions that followed him in the battlefield. And sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.